September 25th, the new Fox Tuesday kicks off with New Girl's new season. Then welcome Ben and Kate.
Stay away from my sister before you find out what 6 years of Prob Maga feels like. Well, like year and a half plus like 4 years on and off I was traveling.
Followed by another all-new New Girl.
What am I looking at here?
Pure, unadulterated friendship.
And the Mindy Project.
Can't believe you're tattling.
Tattling is when a little girl does it, okay? When a hot woman does it, it's called whistleblowing.
The new Fox Tuesday, premieres September 25th on Fox.
You're listening to the AfterBuzz TV Network, now the largest new media platform on the web and your number one source for after-show entertainment.
Very good, Dean
Johnson.
The AfterBuzz Studios in Los Angeles, California. Presented by Maria Menounos and Bing.com. And streaming live thanks to Akamai Technologies. This is AfterBuzz TV's Awkward After Show. We'll break down tonight's episode and get you all the latest news and gossip. If you'd like to buzz in on tonight's show, you can buzz us at 424-256-1729. That's 424-256-1729. And now, another post-game wrap-up show for your favorite TV show. It's AfterBuzz TV's Awkward After Show.
Hello, everybody. Bing is for doing, and we are here. We are loud. Thank you, Annie, for letting me know. I told you, I don't even need a mic. I could probably not have a mic. Everybody on the internet could hear me. Bing is for doing, and we're here doing another really fun episode of Awkward titled Once Upon a Blog, which, you know what, I think I'm just slow. All this stuff comes to me like after. Of course it's called Once Upon a Blog. Season 2, episode 11, one more show after this.
Wow, one more.
Yeah, I think we should have done, what if, like, Crystal was the host? I should have made you do all that first stuff and not told you. And then it would have been awkward.
Yeah, super
no.
awkward.
So, this was in... I'm the old man in the room, so all this stuff was like, I was trying to follow it, but in the comic book world, as, you know, from a young kid till even now, we're beeping. is the food ready?
I thought it was a fire alarm for a second.
Okay, like, so, no, John's working out our technical difficulties, but no, it's cool. So, no, I'm watching this thing in the comic world, we call this a what if. This
a
is called
if.
A what if episode, Once Upon a Blog. So much fun.
Yeah, yes. I love the idea.
I made a comment to Ed and Annie during the show that I usually don't like these episodes, and I'm like, oh, here we go again. You know, because
yeah, you were
see.
A little bit of a hater in the beginning. You were like, oh, man, this is that flashback crap.
Well, yeah, because I want to see, you know, new things, and I was so into it.
Yeah.
I'm never, never disappointed with this show. The writing is just, it's always so good.
Yeah, and I like the different scenarios. There was a lot going on.
Yes. There was a lot going on. We're going to talk about all of it. But I had, I'm not going to call it an epiphany, mm-hmm. but I had something occur to me.
What's that?
By watching this today. This one, I want to know what you guys think. Okay, so most of the time when I watch movies or whatever that are fiction, you know, I just sit back and I let the story kind of just wash over my brain and let it entertain me. And I'm like, oh, wow, that was awesome. Not ever once thinking that any of it was born from reality. Like, I'm thinking that a fiction writer sits, you know, and goes, okay, I'm a writer, and then he sits and gets an idea, and then he just makes up this story and this plot. You know what? What if the writer, when she was in high school, had a Maddie and a Jake, and she went through this?
Yeah.
I was thinking, I'm actually was sitting there thinking, I'll bet you this is what happened here.
Yeah.
Some version, right?
Yeah.
I wouldn't be surprised at all.
And
yeah, definitely. Because when I watched 90210 and it's Aaron Spelling and he lived in Beverly Hills, I'm like, this is what people in Southern California that are rich are really like. Because he's coming up with these situations that he's probably heard about or knows people that have gone.
The new 90210?
The old. I'm talking about the old. I don't watch the new one, sorry.
No, but and then I realized, you know what? One of the most successful shows on television, Law & Order, is...
Yeah. Based on real cases.
Yeah. And then going back to something that came on TV when I was a little kid, you guys don't know, and actually it was reruns even when I was a kid, was Dragnet. Dragnet was a police show where they had, in, at the end of the show, it would basically be like a Law and Order, but it was only like a half hour show.
Yeah.
And it was in the 60s, so it was really all proper. And it was, you know, the police officer talked like, you know. And anyway, at the end of it, you know, the whatever the crime would be, the bad guys would get caught, and it would say, you know, so-and-so went to jail. And they would say the names were changed to protect the innocent, you know, all that stuff. And Law and Order, of course, ripped from the headlines is their catch line. Anyway, I say all that to say that it kind of made me, I mean, the writing's still awesome, but I was like, you know what, it's kind of a jip. You know, there's a Jake and a Maddie on your show because you had it in real life.
Yeah.
You know,
and then the popular and the unpopular kind of is like, everyone kind of knows what that's like.
I do think a lot of it is very, the humor in it is definitely modern, though. Just how witty everything is. So I appreciate that.
And the lingo.
Even if it's loosely based off real.
Oh, my God. The
writing.
Listen,
it's just so good.
The writing in the show is Awesome Town.
Yeah. High five,
right?
Ed.
Awesome
Coming
Town.
Coming up with a Tam.
The writing is Awesome Town.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, there's a guy in the show that has a Jufro.
Oh, my gosh.
I'm the guy with the Jufro. Whoa.
That was funny.
It's hilarious. Okay, but anyway, that was my epiphany that happened. So Jenna is basically sitting on her computer, getting ready to blog like she does. And she just is basically deciding, you know what? I don't want to have to choose. And so she decides to blog it out.
Yeah, she thinks that, you know, instead of, what was it? She thought going through her past, she could trace her steps and figure out what one to go with.
Yep, so she starts blogging, and now...
She's so excited. Yep.
No, she starts blogging. I mean, see, this is the part that, that I loved, you know, from previous episodes, recent previous episodes, where because the blog went public, now all of a sudden the people in the show that are playing characters in the high school are like Team Maddie, Team Jake, all the stuff that we were doing, you know, for two seasons. Yeah, so it's the reality show in the reality show, inside the show. And now she's got people watching her blog like it's a TV show. Yeah. And they're waiting to see what she types. And they're, you know, chatting with her in the blog. So one of them says, what would you do if you could have a do-over? And that's when she's like, you know what? I'm going to have my do-over fantasy. And she starts with refusing to get in the closet.
Yes.
And you know, it totally reads like a PSA, right?
Yeah.
She's like, no, I'm not going to go in there because if I do, we're going to have sex. And then you're not going to respect me. You're not going to value me enough to tell me, you know, to tell your friends and I'm your boyfriend.
Yeah, so why don't you ask me out on a date first and walks away? That was good. Brilliant.
So good.
It was like therapeutic. I could see how.
I love how they made it. They made it like a what if scenario, but at the same time, it was almost as if we were hearing what Jenna, I mean, we were hearing what Jenna was thinking in her own head, and she was changing the story as she went along. And that was really fun instead of just like seeing this fake like what if scenario.
It was so fun to see Maddie defending Jenna to Sadie.
And that whole scene was that was great.
Really funny.
I mean, I can't describe enough how it's like we didn't even know, because you know, the whole experience of watching the show was like satisfying. Like, you know, we didn't even know how much we wished we could have seen that.
You know what it is too, is a show like this and how they did it is everything that we as viewers would be like, I wonder what it would be like if Jenna was the popular girl.
Yeah, or, you know, they show you
like,
it.
You think about that, and so you get to see that, and you love it. Like you love it. You know, it made me appreciate who Jenna is.
She is for real. Yeah.
Right? Did you guys get that?
Yes. No, it did. And or you watch it and you say, you know what, man. If she had just done this, then he would have said this, and then they would have done this.
Yeah, all this would have come out of one decision.
Yeah.
So good.
Yeah, like, okay, if Jenna's mom hadn't written the letter.
Yeah.
Right? And so in Jenna's do-over fantasy, she says, you know what? You might want to rethink that.
Yeah, that was hilarious.
I mean, it's like, whoa, yeah, then Jenna doesn't get the letter, and none of that happens. And,
and then her mom loves her and writes the letter.
Yes.
She's perfect and stuff.
And her
Jenna's
mom.
A bitch.
Oh. I mean, and the parents don't break up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Funny stuff.
Yeah, but I think, you know, it was somehow, you know, therapeutic for me, too, to see it. Because I feel relieved. I'm like, oh, okay. You know, everything's
now
okay
we know
now.
It wouldn't have worked out.
Yeah, like that didn't really happen. Like as if the show is real anyway.
It's like, you know what? It's in comparison, it's like watching a scary movie and being like, don't go in there. And then we get to see the after show where he doesn't go in there.
He doesn't
he's
go
like,
in.
I'll pass.
It's kind of similar to, like, have you guys seen the movie The Butterfly Effect?
Yes.
Yes.
With Ashton Kutcher, and he goes back, and that's a little more serious and crazy, but it's similar.
Okay, now, and here's another genius effect that happened here. Imagine, okay, so we watched this today, and we're thinking, this is like bordering on one of our favorite shows of the series, okay?
Yeah.
We're loving it, and we're entertained by this fairly boring material that's happening. The only reason we like it, it's exciting because we saw the bad stuff first.
Yeah.
Like, if we had seen this first, it would have been like, it wouldn't have been funny.
Yeah.
Right.
It would have been, like, totally cheesy for Sadie to go, "You're a bitch. I like you." You know, it's so much more funny now because we know that's
didn't
happen.
Yeah.
Anyway, so the result of, and I like how you guys put it, or one of you put it, the title here is, I titled this section that she refused to go in the closet, but this is the Team Maddie part.
Yeah.
Team Maddie.
Okay. So this is the one where she turns into a mean, raging bitch, right? The first one.
Right.
First do-over
and
fantasy.
And a hot bitch at that. Can we just comment
on
how
amazing.
They downplay Jenna's beauty a lot. Because she's a little hottie.
Way she is. She's
Hamilton.
Got beautiful skin, really good bone structure, and they, like, emphasize her eyes
and the
lips. They
put makeup on her for once. Yeah.
That I can tell. I can tell that eye makeup made the look.
Yeah.
Like,
and
her
the
eyes.
It was the eyes. It was
and definitely the
eyes
lips,
and
too,
the lips.
Dark red.
I was staring at her lips.
Yeah, she has really full lips that you wouldn't know otherwise because she doesn't usually wear anything.
Talking about this episode makes me realize how much I really loved it, even more than I knew.
Right.
Right.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Okay. So she's like, she turns into this raging bitch. She's mean to everybody. She's like,
including
front of Val.
Mom.
Including her mom, but in front of Val, she's like Sadie, the equivalent of Sadie.
Yeah.
Like, Val is
scared
of her.
She's such a good bitch.
Yeah. Val is scared of her, and she's all mean, and it was like the catch line that she had to say was like, "Oh, she's like, sorry, I'm not sorry."
Yeah.
It reminded me of the Asian mafia, Rebecca.
Becca.
Yeah, yeah.
Remember who she would laugh and she'd go, "Ha ha," and then.
I love that.
Yeah,
where
I do too.
Was she?
I do too. That
we
was funny.
We could have seen, like, what if it wouldn't have happened with the Asian mafia?
Yeah.
They would have been. They only have 20 minutes of show time.
Yeah.
18. Let's not 18. Get ahead of ourselves.
Yeah, that's becoming a complaint.
Can we get a little bit less commercial?
That's becoming a complaint of ours now. Well, you know what? With the show becoming, you know, third season more popular, we're going to have more reason for more commercial.
Yeah, more advertising.
But totally convincing, come walking around the corner. She's like, what did she say right before that scene? "I'm not going to become Sadie's BFF just because, you know, blah, blah, blah." And then, boom, come walking around the corner. She's a cheerleader or song leader, whichever one it is.
Girls. Fabulous. Yeah. It is like was Mean Girls.
And decides to drop her friends. We got another line there from.
We did.
She had a nice wardrobe, gang swatch.
So wardrobe is awesome.
Wardrobe, like, yes, of course, wardrobe. It's awesome.
I know.
And so, you know, but for whatever reason, her in that do-over, and I don't know why, like, she was writing the do-over.
Yeah.
It's, you know, why did she write herself as such a bitch that, like, sent Maddie running away?
I guess she just thought that that's who she would have become if she had been in that situation and been dealt. I mean, when you get a chance to be the popular girl and
from
you
going
were,
from that to that,
then, you know, she was just being real with herself.
Man.
In all circumstances.
Wow.
She was just way too into herself and was a bitch.
And Jake comes through and tells Maddie, "Dude,
she's dating, a raging bitch."
Yeah. Come on, dude. Everybody sees it.
Yeah.
Know? And then he goes to Ming.
That was, like, a little far-fetched. Yeah. I thought it was going to be... Actually, I don't know who I thought it was going to be. Who did you think it would be?
I was thinking Tamara. Or Tamara. I didn't know.
Well, you know what? I didn't know. In fact, when he was describing the girl, he's like, "You know what? I'm into somebody else. They're off the grid. They're, like..." He described, like, they're plain.
Yeah.
You know, they're normal. They're whatever. In my mind, he was describing the real Jenna.
Right, right.
You know, and I'm thinking...
Oh, yeah.
Like
which
there's
makes
a,
sense.
Yeah, there's another Jenna. Like, Ming was a total shock to me. And meaningless because it's just like... And we're going to talk about it because it's funny, but it's just like how she ended the third do-over.
Right,
it's like she just made up, you know, what would be weird to her, I'm sure.
Yeah.
You know? Okay, so that was refusal to go in the closet. aka the Team Maddie do-over. I would like to pause and remind our listeners that we are, like I said before, guys, we are still on iTunes. All of our shows are podcasts that you can subscribe to and now stream on the go with the podcast app. You can also rate us and comment. That's what we need. We need all of you who listen to rate, comment, tell a friend, and that's going to help us out in the long run, short run and the long run, so we appreciate it. And then I called it the refusal to kiss the Team Jake do-over.
Yep.
Okay. So the do-over for her would be, instead of like letting things happen the way they happened, she pushes Jake away, says, look, if we're going to do this, let's do it right. You break up with Alyssa, I'll break up with Maddie, then we'll get together, and in the end, I would be choosing you anyway, so trust me, you're going to be happy with me, and blah, blah, blah. It's hilarious.
And when she tells him about Maddie's the guy
that I've been in love
that
with.
That was what I wanted to hear and see. That was great.
Right? Just get it all out there.
Of it.
Yeah, he just took it all in, then he was like, okay, like at least she's up front.
Now... Now, tell me why, though. I didn't understand why she told Maddie the way she told him. Remember, she's like, I want to break up.
You know, that made me think, and I'm trying to think back to, like, the beginning of the season or whenever it was, and I'm thinking, like, when that happened, they had so much crap going on that I feel like it would have been out of place for Jenna to be like, we're breaking up. I'm breaking up with you. Because they weren't officially together, even though they kind of were via hooking up. But they, you know what I mean? Like, it just would have seemed out of place if that had happened during that time in the series.
Yeah, it's like to this, you know, right now, up until now, Maddie has never said to anybody, me and Jenna are together.
Right.
Yeah.
So, yeah, for her to go say, you know, I think we should break up, you know, he could have easily said, break what up?
I would have enjoyed something more along the lines of, you treat me like crap, I'm going to be with someone who appreciates me and can be with me in public.
Yeah.
Too little, too late.
Yeah, I didn't understand why she, even in her do-over fantasy, why she was just like walked over there with the attitude and said, actions are louder than words, that's why I'm going to go be with your best friend.
Yeah.
You know, it was along the lines of, you know, laying it all out there, but didn't understand the reason to be mean to Maddie.
Right.
You know, except, you know, or like you said.
Unless it was basing it off of what they were and how they hooked up, but he wasn't going to tell
anybody.
Yeah,
you could articulate it, but I didn't understand the,
right.
You know. Like, I wish I had the writer here to explain it to, because I'm sure it was like, it's I'm wrong and they're right, you know.
That's the exact reason that we don't know.
Okay, so she didn't kiss Jake, and then when she was explaining everything to him, he's all, this is a whole lot to process.
Yeah, he's like, whoa.
I'm like, yeah, dude, it's like, what's that move? It's like Butterfly Effect. It's like she went back, and she's got all this knowledge, and she's like explaining. She said, look, dude, here's what's going to happen. This is what we need to do and so that it doesn't go wrong, and everything's going to be good. Trust me, you'll be happy.
Yeah.
You know, she knows she has all this knowledge in her little do-over fantasy. It's funny. And so they do the mutual breakup, and then they get together, and then they say, well, Jake experiences what I say all the time, is that there is no chemistry.
Yeah.
And he even asked.
What I say all the time? That's what you say all the time?
I say that all the time. There is no chemistry between Jake and Jenna.
Oh, I thought you meant, like, what you say in your own personal life.
There's no chemistry.
I was like, what?
No.
You know what? Not to cut you off, but this made me think about, we never actually, or did we have confirmation that Jake and Jenna slept together? Because remember that they left the episode open-ended?
I think they didn't.
Nah, wait, remind me, because I'm forgetting, please.
Did they
ever end up doing it?
No, they didn't.
They didn't, right?
Yeah, so that makes me wonder, like,
if they would have.
Is this foreshadowing to next week's episode?
Nah.
Well, if that's what Jenna is predicting, then maybe she.
Predicting? She's not predicting anything. She was doing a do-over fantasy.
Yes, but in her head, she's writing it, so it's her prediction.
Yeah, maybe she's just doing
this. Well, which one? They're all different.
All of it. It's coming from her little mind.
I think she's doing it because she's going to help remember that this is the right decision just to be by herself. She's taking both scenarios and they don't work out. So she's kind of like, okay, let me just.
All I'm wondering is why she chose to have the chemistry be bad between them.
Well, it wasn't bad for her. She thought, you know, her friends are saying, dude, he's going to pump and dump. Okay. And she's like, we're in love.
And then he got the we need to talk tag action.
You're in love.
You're in love. She needed a sexorcism because she.
There's so many good ones.
What was it? Because she. See, sex, because she was in a sex trance.
Sex trance, yes.
And
think of the word.
Annie, your favorite line that Tamara said.
Put it. Wait, what is it? Drop it, flip it, reverse
put that
it.
Thing down, flip it, and reverse
yeah,
it.
The yeah, the Missy Elliott
you need
song.
To back it up. Yeah.
That was hilarious.
So funny. It's the little details.
I know.
Yeah. No. And
I'm just thinking, like, 12 or 13 year olds watching this wouldn't know what that means.
Right.
But
yeah.
They know that they have an older audience where, like, that song was popular when we were younger.
Yeah. Right.
So we can
exactly
relate. Love that.
Because that's like from the 90s.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The late 90s.
Yeah, yeah. There might be some people watching it that are not.
Fall.
Yeah. They're born in 2000.
Right?
Yeah. Born. Yes.
Born in
but
2000.
I also caught and you know it just it tickled me to death that. Was the reversal of her saying to Jake, I love you, and he goes, awesome.
Awesome, and walks away.
Which is exactly what happened when he said it.
It's the reverse that happened. And I thought, you know what, that's you can't beat that.
Yeah.
That is awesome.
That was good.
And
that
she,
was smart.
And she turned to her friends, just like he turned to Maddie. He goes, you know, I told him when Jake said to Maddie, I told her I love her. And he goes, all right, well, do you love her? Yeah, but we know what she said back. Awesome. So that was hilarious. But it is funny. Jake feels no chemistry. She's in a sex trance.
Mm-hmm.
And she goes to Val and gets all this advice, but goes the old-fashioned way.
As Val, only Val would suggest doing this. The counselor
God.
At the school.
Don't you remember when she when she thought she was having, when she came in, Jenna came and talked to Val about a problem she was having with, I think, Sadie.
Yeah.
And Val was trying to, basically, without saying it, trying to tell her to fight her, but off of school grounds.
Right.
She's like, you need to. And had a sign that said, not on school grounds. Like,
she's hilarious.
Yeah, it is hilarious. Anyway, advises her to fake a pregnancy or, you know, whatever.
Yeah, the old tradition or the classic trick or whatever. I don't know what she used to describe it.
Yeah. Yeah. The
old-fashioned way.
Old-fashioned.
Yeah.
And whatever, Jake overhears it and says, I would love that cute baby. It was just, it was
yeah,
all
it was really funny.
This corny fiction that Jenna was writing. I mean, and the genius of it is somebody wrote the story of a girl writing a story.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
It's just so entertaining and so fun. And then for her story to have be so flawed.
Yeah.
It's just, you know, it's just like it's genius.
And then the parents give her the pregnancy test.
And she's actually pregnant. I was like, dude. And it said, it all spelled out, pregnant.
Yeah,
on
no,
the
she's
little
like,
test.
Pregnant.
I love that.
Yeah, and it made me think, why don't the little test say that anyway?
I think some of them do. They have, like, different kinds.
Really?
Smiley
they got ones
face,
that say...
line.
There's the line, the two line.
Yeah.
Yeah, what's all these
I
lines?
I think there's one that says pregnant, not pregnant, too.
I think there is.
Really?
They have, yeah. like, 1,000 different
I think
ones.
You're right.
Yeah.
Personally, I think that whole line thing is... like, whoa.
Like,
yeah,
why
confusing
at all?
Don't make it confusing.
Which, and Maddie had a truly funny comment walking by pregnant Jenna, which you picked up on, saying, yeah. dodged a bullet.
Yeah, yeah, he's all dodged a bullet.
So funny.
And it was like a pillow, obviously. Yeah. Totally fake on purpose,
so
which was funny.
Oh, man. Okay, so.
So it didn't work out with either of those scenarios.
Nope. flawed fiction. X is what Jenna was writing there. And I think they, in the beginning, both of them started out all good, right?
Right.
Yeah.
But they just kind of fizzled and fell apart as
yeah.
they got to the
yeah.
end, right?
In the beginning, you were like, oh, this could be good.
And yeah, because, you know, and that's hindsight. Hindsight will tell you exactly what you should have done at a certain point, but it doesn't tell you what would have happened after.
Right.
You know, mm-hmm. that. So. I mean, it, again, genius writing.
And you can think so deeply into it, and you can relate it to your own life and maybe things that you've done in your past and thought about, thinking like, God, I wish I had done that differently. Or like, what yeah. would have happened if that didn't happen or if that did happen?
Right.
So yeah. relatable.
I think yeah. it was aspect. A good episode for the fans, too,
yeah.
who are wondering about what could have happened, and then they show all
yeah.
of it.
Yep. You can recreate that one moment where you know you did something, you know, you want to do something different, you should have, but
yeah.
you can't recreate what would happen
exactly.
after, you know, not like, so it's perfect. So for the third do-over fantasy, she refuses to choose and then has, well, and this is the shortest one. Maybe
yeah.
maybe because they were only at the 14-minute mark.
Yeah, they had like
almost.
A minute to wrap that one.
but so she's walking by these people that usually create all kinds of drama, Val and Sadie, and this slow-mo. I didn't get it. You had to tell
yeah.
me. You know, and then they slow-mo walk by and nothing happens because there's no
there's
reason.
There's no drama.
Right.
There's no drama.
You know what I'm just realizing, too, is what? I don't know if it was the last episode that we had or the one before that, but in our predictions, we talked about who we thought Jenna would choose, and some of us were Maddie, some of us were Jake, yes. and some of us were no one.
And so we got all of that.
We got to see it all. Wow.
I love that.
Oh, man. What
and then
is
she's going to camp. Is that how they closed the last one?
She didn't go to camp.
She's going to school.
Summer school. To graduate
early.
Yeah,
so she gets out of high school early. She's like not interested in anything social or boys.
Yeah.
And then they bump into her, Jake and Maddie, and help her pick up her books. And then she basically writes first that they walked away without knowing her name, without, you know, noticing her at all.
Right.
And then she
hand in hand with girlfriends, mind you.
And then she erased that and rewrote that they held hands and came out of the closet.
So funny.
Yeah, that was real. It was funny how she did it. Like she was being sneaky or evil or something, you know. It was so funny.
I can't believe there's only one episode left.
I'm so excited.
It's
going to
be
season
a cliffhanger.
Three.
Something about maybe the 2-week hiatus little thing we had, the break, and then this show being awesome and fun, but not a plot thickener at all.
No, right. Nothing
you
really
know, this
changed
is like, yeah,
yet.
This is total parallel.
Well, I feel like, and this is getting into predictions a little bit, but I feel like with the preview that they gave us for next week, she's going to make her decision in the beginning of the episode, and then something's going to happen afterwards.
Yeah.
Oh my God, I just had a great prediction.
Okay. Well, let's talk about, because you saw.
I'm going to forget it. No, I can't forget it.
Oh, wait, we could do the news and gossip
now. We'll do it now. Let's do it now. Let's do it now. Your thing now.
Sorry.
Because
I don't have any news and gossip. Do you guys have news and gossip?
Well,
I just have the one
does.
Thing about.
Oh, you do. You do. Okay. I won't forget.
You're not going to forget?
I'm not going to forget. I'm writing it in my memory.
It's elephants.
We only have a few minutes left
anyway. It's elephants that don't forget, not cat ladies. Anyway, because she's a cat lady.
Watch it.
Should I?
Oh, you're going to go to the cat thing with Nikki? Nikki.
Oh, yes.
Are you?
I want to. I was driving today and I saw a sign for the Santa Monica cat show and I was like, oh, I need to go. Because Nikki was here in studio.
You should tweet her and ask her what day she's going.
Oh, yes.
Those are other people's cats. Why is that exciting?
Trust me, it's exciting. I just want to see. She mentioned
your cat.
I think you can. I don't know, but she was mentioning how crazy people get with their cats, and I think that's so hilarious. Like, don't touch. Hands off the merch.
Hands off the merch. Okay, so you, my dear, were at MTV VMAs.
Yeah, so I worked the VMAs. I worked with this audience coordinating company for like the last 4 years. Anyways, so I worked the VMAs, and the whole cast of Awkward was in the audience, and I got to see them all close up, which was really exciting because Maddie is so good looking.
Shocker.
Nikki DeLoach came in walking down the aisle, like having a good time, like recording everyone because everyone was cheering on the floor. And
she
like,
would,
the
too.
DJ, yeah. She was like, had her fist up.
Yeah, she's in love with the world. She like loves everybody.
Oh, I know.
Yeah.
She's like so energetic. But Ashley, how do you say her last name?
Rickards.
Yeah. Was there. She actually like walked past me. I did not recognize her. She is blonde now.
Yes.
And very thin. Like very real thin.
And she has bangs now too, right?
Yeah. Well, she kind of had them to the side. Yeah. She had her hair down and she was wearing a dress, and it was a dress that like cinched at the waist.
Yeah.
And it was like.
It was really pretty.
Very.
So she's back to her season one figure.
Yeah. I mean. Yeah. Yeah.
Super. Okay.
And I don't know what was up with the blonde hair. She also tweeted something about not only do blondes have more fun, but it's time to take something about taking advantage of now, now she wants to try this look. And
well, my first reaction was I didn't like the blonde, but as I got a closer look, I thought it looks totally Hollywood, and
it works.
I think it works. I think it makes her look older, and I prefer her brown.
I think she looks better
definitely
as a brunette because her skin tone is very light.
Yeah.
She probably gets a little bit of anonymity, or did when she was blonde.
She could probably go red and look good, I bet. Or brownish reddish.
I agree though. I think she probably as a brunette would be is the best thing for her.
Yeah.
And
so that's my story, that's all.
That's
I just saw her and
that's her Twitter pic too.
I didn't recognize her. Yeah.
Yeah.
And if you like Google red carpet VMAs, you'll see her.
MTV actually and the Awkward page on Facebook had a big do you like Jenna's new look type of thing.
Yeah.
So.
Oh.
Yeah.
Did you see the results of the poll?
I didn't. Oh, no, okay. I should have.
I would have voted yes.
Yeah.
I voted yes. Okay, so we are going to talk about what you predict.
Predictions?
Yeah, and then we're going to talk about some cool stuff that Fox has coming up.
Okay, so official predictions.
Yes.
Okay. Do you want to go first?
No, we're going to start at that end of the room.
I'll start by making it quick and sweet. I think that she is going to not choose either. But she does hook up with someone in the preview. But I'm thinking that someone could be someone else.
Mm. Okay.
That's all.
I have two predictions. The first is I think she's going to go with Maddie. I do, even though there's a little piece of me that's going to, you know.
Yeah.
Okay.
Jake, but I think
where's
Maddie.
Where's this epiphany that you had?
She's getting to
the
it.
The epiphany is, this is my second prediction, is that when her parents walk in and say, surprise, or guess what, they're going to say, we're pregnant. Yes.
Wow.
I think she's going to have a little sister or brother, and that's going to be in season three. I think that's the whole new funny thing. I mean, the parents have to go somewhere. The storyline has to continue.
Right.
With them, I think there's going to be a baby.
Or what if they're like, we're moving?
Oh, no, I don't think they'll move.
But I feel like whenever a show introduces a baby, it's because the ratings are low. And they try to, like, like, I don't know, that's what it's been in the past. But that can't be the case.
Yeah, it's
so
not
maybe
the case here.
It's just a wild twist if they have a baby.
I think there's going to be a child.
Let me ask, how, because it's been, like, it feels like a year ago that we saw the other awkward show, the other episode. How did that, where were we at? What ended? I mean, we pick up with this one, and she's, you know, deciding.
Jenna saw the letter. She opened, they had the prom.
Yeah.
And she saw Maddie, and Maddie saw her with Jake, and he was really bummed. And Jenna found out that he went to her house and that she wasn't there. And then she went home. The alarm was going off. She called her mom, opened the drawer, and saw the letterhead. So the.
Well, no, that was the end of season one.
Wait, isn't that what we're talking about?
No.
No, the
I'm
end of the last episode before
this one. Oh, I just zoned
one.
Out. I just zoned out hardcore.
It's okay. She's tired. It's okay.
Oh, my God. You cat lady.
I was thinking about.
You are all sleepy.
I think.
Yeah. You just skipped the whole season.
Okay,
I think
last episode
was the two of them sitting there, and she said, you can date each other.
You're right.
Yeah, well, I know that was the
talking.
Episode.
Oh, what's your question?
The question was, like, what exactly did we leave it on? What was the tension?
Oh, no.
But, it's, you know, we picked it up where she's having to choose.
I'm not sure.
Anyway.
Wait, did we talk about the Twilight thing?
No, we didn't.
That was
the Twilight thing was,
you know,
a
that was like
hilarious.
That was like before the do-overs. That was like
was like the first, because she was narrating it.
Jake walking in with his werewolf.
Oh my
yeah,
God,
the hair
yeah.
coming
was
out.
So
that
funny.
Was funny because Twilight is such a hit, but it's really not that great.
It's not that great. And he.
It's for like 12
I think he was wearing a sweater in that scene.
Yes, to the viewers and listeners, I had this moment where I really, really, really wanted to be a detective because they showed the preview and we saw an arm on the side of the bed when Jenna's parents came in. So we knew that there was someone else in the room. And I'm like, oh, my goodness. I saw a gray sleeve with a maroon cuff. Let's rewind. And we look back.
Wearing the spin the bottle scene.
Yes, in the spin the bottle scene. And there was no gray and maroon sweater. So
okay, now,
is that a loss?
My prediction was going to be that I don't think the guy that is on the side of the bed, God, I want to say that it's not either one of them.
But
that's what I think.
But not necessarily a guy that she's hooking up with, though.
I don't think they're going to bring a new boy in.
Yeah, I don't think they're going to bring a new boy, but I'm not convinced that that's either Maddie or Jake.
Or maybe it's one of them and they're just talking. It's not like they're hooking up.
Yeah,
that's
maybe
true.
Something like that.
It could be misleading.
Yeah.
But
MTV likes
we're
to
gonna
do that.
Watch anyway, so.
Yeah, we're going to, I mean, honestly, we are either going to be really impressed or we're going to be disappointed. And we have never been disappointed yet.
I think it's going to be a great finale.
It will.
I do.
Well, and we know because we've had Molly Tarloff, we've had Jillian Rose Reed, we've had Nikki DeLoach, and they all told us that the season finale is going to be awesome.
What could, like, what's something crazy that could happen? Something so crazy.
What could they do
crazy?
In 14 minutes?
I don't know. We'll find out.
Think about it. The reality is we're talking about an upcoming 14 minutes of show.
Yeah. I know.
And well, it's like going to blow our minds, and then we're going to have to wait, like, until next season.
I know.
Oh, man. Well, the other prediction I have is lots of laughs on Tuesday night, Fox Tuesday. So what we have is we have three shows that I personally have seen before. The New Girl, I've seen a couple of episodes of, and I'm, you know, I don't know why I don't watch them because it's awesome.
Oh,
and
yeah. My friends are huge.
Yeah.
We're
it
all
is
fans.
Zoe Deschanel, is that how you say it?
Yeah.
She's back for another season of New Girl, September 25th, Tuesday. But I also want to mention that I watched, and you guys didn't see yet, but I want you guys to watch it just because it's so good. The Mindy Project, I saw the pilot for that and the pilot for Ben and Kate. And it is laugh out loud funny.
Yeah.
Laugh out loud funny. So
is it 30 minutes?
They are all 30-minute shows, Well, wait, New Girl, 30-minute show.
30, yeah, I believe. Okay. Yeah.
Definitely Mindy Project and Ben and Kate, which, by the way, for the record, you get about 23 minutes of content.
Oh, five extra minutes.
That's
MTV,
nice.
Take lessons.
Yeah, what's up with that?
Take lessons.
But some hilarious laugh-out-loud scenes. My prediction is that anybody who gives Fox Tuesday Night a chance is going to be hooked. They got a lock on some new style of good writing that is just, like I said, laugh-out-loud.
And we love that.
Yeah,
and that's a good night to watch TV. What else are you doing on Tuesday?
There you go.
Besides listening to AfterBuzz.
That's true. We do have shows. Oh, my God. Competition. No, but Fox Tuesday, September 25th. Tune in. Starts at 8 o'clock. Watch and have fun. All right, guys. For me, your host, Ed Bowling, at Ed Bowling on Twitter.
And I'm Crystal Ackley, at Crystal Lee on Twitter.
And I'm Annie Demian, at Annie Demian. I'm getting more into Twitter now, tweeting every day. So follow me.
Do you have an I in the Twitter name, too?
Annie, it's like A-N-N-I-E.
I swear to God, I'm going to find you.
Anne is, my first name is Anne Marie, but yeah. I go by Annie.
How
we've been over
just,
this.
Are you just going to put an extra I in there whenever you feel like it?
It's like my nickname since I was a little kid. I never was called anything else.
Okay, nicknames, okay.
So Annie is I-E, yeah.
There
like
you go.
The movie.
All right. Next week, guys. See ya.
Oh, yeah. Season finale.
Yay.
Woo.
From Bing.com, executive producers Maria Menounos, Kevin Undergaro, Phil Svitek, and the entire AfterBuzz TV staff, we would like to thank you for listening to the AfterBuzz TV network. To watch or listen to other after shows and post comments or questions, be sure to visit AfterBuzzTV.com. I'm Sir Richard Wentworth, and this has been a presentation of AfterBuzz TV.
You're welcome.
The views expressed herein are those of the hosts only and do not necessarily reflect the views of AfterBuzz TV or its owners or principals.